Hello everyone, it's Nisha with Inspiring Beautiful Creations. I'm here today to share with you a swap that I'm actually a part of. It was an individual swap that I'm swapping with Scrapdaworld, who is Tmika, and it was on her Instagram page actually that she put out a challenge to create an embellishment box. And I accepted the challenge, and the theme of this particular challenge was supposed to be shabby chic. I'm not someone who's ever thought that I made anything that was shabby chic, but apparently, I guess, you know, in shabby chic, when I did the research, was really about colors and making things look more antique-ish or whitewashed or, you know, rustic in my mind, kind of like antique-ish in that kind of way. So when I put out this thought in my head, like, what can I create? What can I do? It's just about embellishments. I was like, what's shabby to me? What's a shabby chic project to me that I like, that I would like to share with someone? And what I came up with was, as you can see my little tag here, I kind of went with a denim theme. I kind of, you know, went ahead and used real actual denim, and then I had some denim paper in my stash, and I roughed it up a little bit here, as you can see, and distressed it a little bit and speckled it and all kinds of stuff just to make it where I thought it looked shabby for me. So I'm going to show you the embellishment box that I created, and here it is. This is my embellishment box, and you know, this is just a flower, and I added some more shabbiness, as I thought, to it by adding some strips of the denim, because like as I worked with the denim fabric, it kind of shred as I pulled and things like that. So I want to incorporate that in this particular flower, and it just has a nice little pearl setting inside here. But I created a belly band, so to speak, so it just slides off, and I actually used some of these flowers. These flowers were actually white, so I tea stained them so that for they could kind of match this overall theme of this antique-ish look to me, of the shabbiness. I also created a little tag here. I created and said, create beautiful things, because I feel like everything that's in this box creates something else that's beautiful with it. And then I wanted to give my box a little name and let them know why I chose, or let her know why I chose the denim, because I called it the shabby blues. So I thought that was like a little cute. So I just made these tags again with the denim, and I, you know, roughed it up just to make it look more, a little bit more shabby. So I'm going to take the band off, so that way we can see the contents of what's inside the box. I got this box from the Dollar Tree. Excuse me. Still getting over allergies. I guess this is what this is called now. But in this particular box, like I said, I called it the shabby blue. So I kept everything in that blue and that cream and, you know, that shabby look to me. So, but this is one of those boxes that everybody's getting from the Dollar Tree. And it's one of the thicker boxes. I'm not sure if you can see the depth. But what I did was I had some pearls in here, because I always think that, you know, you can make creative things with the pearls. So I kind of went with the same colors, the pearls, the creams, and then a little bit of the pearlized browns. These are some tissue paper flowers here, and I actually handmade these tissue paper flowers here from some tissue paper that had script printing on them. I thought that was cute. And I also handmade these denim flowers. I just had some denim fabric paper, and I went ahead and I used my Heartfelt Creations, and then I also put some whitewash on it just to give it a little bit more of a shabby appeal to it. So I had two different sizes in there. These were a little harder to make because that denim fabric is not as easy to work with. So here we have those. I also added some of these little, as you saw in my cards, there's this little flower here, or this little cut paper flower here. So I gave some of those. It's like in a couple of different colors. So I put some of those in these little boxes. I mean, little jars, I call them, that I also got from the Dollar Tree. I put some white ones in here as well. And then this one, it's just a sequence mix. It's got several different colors of the blues and the whites and the opaque, and then some seed beads and things like that to make a nice little shaker card. It looks like a little, but this sequence goes a long way. On this side, what I chose to do was I had some words, wooden word pieces here that actually say, wake up and live. And I actually did some more whitewashing. I colored it, stained it with some blues and whites and creams, and I just speckled it. I had a lot of fun making this because I've never done that before. So this was kind of fun for me, and just to get kind of messy. But I did get messy as I was creating these. But those are the words. And I have some clothespins, and I did the same thing. I just kind of gave it that shabby look to it, and she can create whatever she wants to with these. And I just left some in there that were natural, and then I had these that were also with the flower. And I figured, let me keep these kind of natural, so then that way they can create whatever they want, because again, I want them to create, I want her to create beautiful things. In this particular area, I have some beads that I've had from my stash, and I thought because this was that blue and cream that looked kind of really shabby to me. And then I also gave some of these beads that are the flowers, and these are more like the pearlescent, iridescent look. And then some gold and white beads there. So that's all in there here. The next one, I actually have some of these ribbon spools or thread holders. I'm not even sure what you call them, to be honest with you, spools. And I have several of these, and I, you know, wanted to wrap some fabric. So I cut again from the jeans that I actually cut up, an old pair of jeans. I actually cut a strip and then just rolled it around, and I used a little pin to stick it there. I had some denim fabric that came in like rosette pattern that I had, and I wrapped some around this one. And then I had some, just some cream, like an eyelet type lace here, and I wrapped it around that one. So I figured that these are good enough to make some cute little projects with. So we'll put those right back in there. Okay, and then I'll go back here. And then I made some handmade bows. So in this particular card, I made, this is the denim fabric actually from a pair of cut jeans. I scalloped this a little bit and ruched it up and sewed it in the back and just put a little flower on the top. But I used it, that's one bow. A second bow, I used that same rosette ribbon, and I made this into like a bow, and then cut again the jeans and distressed it and put some paint on that. Here I made two tiny little bows. I had to hand cut these out. That was a little hard, but you know, I have fun doing it, and I put a little pearl center in there because I thought I love tiny bows, so they go on anything. And then I made a double bow right here. So again, same with the flower, but this one was just a double bow here. So, and then I just put them on cards actually, and then just went and edged it with some of my blue ink on there. And then here, those same flowers I showed you earlier that were on this card that I T-stained, I T-stained some more of it, and I just kind of gave her some of these, and then I just tied it with some of that leftover denim. And here are some little blue and white flowers. These are not handmade, but I love that they match this blue and white theme when I found them in my stash. So I said that would be cute to add onto cards. It could be added on any little thing to help spruce it up, or, you know. And then I also had some lace that was in my stash, and I cut some of the pieces. I did not tea stain these. I kind of wanted to keep these white because I figured that she could do anything that she wants with these, but I like because they kind of look like it was a bow. So that's back here in the back. Okay, and here I had another one of those flowers left over, so I gave her a flower that she can actually do whatever she wants to with this one if she would like to use that, stick it on top of something because it matches with the top. It filled that space great. And here I have some bling, because if you watch my channel, you'll know that I like a lot of bling. So I just had to add a little bling into there because there's nothing wrong with some shabbiness and some bling. I had a little sticker that I found, and it's actually raised on Pop Dots, but it had a cute saying on it. It says, cherish yesterday, live for today, dream for tomorrow. And I thought that could be put on a card, that could be put on, you know, as an embellishment anywhere on anything. Just glue that down. And I have some beautiful, I'm not sure if we're calling these buttons or just some pieces that were in my stash. And then here's some more bows. Okay, I tried to whitewash just a little bit just to give it a little bit more of an antique kind of look. And then in here, I have some metal word labels, I guess. And you can stick them because they have a little sticker in the back. But they say different things like many thanks, gratitude, inspire, kindness, grateful, you know, thank you. But there's a lot of little words in here, and they're metal, and they'll go on some nice embellishments. So I'm going to move all of this stuff out of the way, because what I'm going to do is show you the other items that I have. So excuse me for one moment. Oops. Okay. Oh, sorry. Shook the camera. I'm so sorry, guys. Now I got to get it back straight again. Okay. So I'm going to put this box to the side. All right, my camera doesn't want to work right now for me today. So we'll work, we'll make it work, right? The other thing I did was, there was the pocket that was left from the jeans, and I thought this would be a cute little pocket to store some things in. So I got some flowers, and I actually painted them, stained them, and speckled them, and whitewashed them, whatever. And then one of those little bow lace pieces I told you I put on here in the pocket, I love because it was kind of distressed, and I thought that's a cute little pocket. And then I made a shaker, and I put some of that denim fabric, the strips, and some other kinds of lace ribbons. And then I stamped the back of the paper. There's some denim here too, and some more of those flowers. But I have shaker pieces in here, but I love the saying. It says, cherish the little things. Sorry for the glare. Cherish the little things. And I kind of felt like this can go on a day planner. This can go in anything. Or it's just a nice little remembrance. But I just thought it was really cute to make. And then I have some magnetic bookmarks here. Sorry for that glare again. I made another denim bow. I put one of those flowers on there and just a little tag. But I cut this out so it could fit in the pocket. But they are book magnets. Backside, front side, they have a saying on them. And what you do is just a page marker, especially if you're using a traveling notebook and you don't like them to be a little bit too bulky, you want to keep it flat. But I thought this really went good with this blue collection for here, or the shabby blues as I'm calling it. So this fits, it tucks right into the pocket. I'm shaking the camera again. I'm sorry, I'm trying a different system. I also made a card. And here on the card, I just, you know, made a little envelope that was a little bit dimensional. And I just put the initial T here with some more of that a blue paper. And then this is the actual card. What I had was some leftover fabric. So what I did was I double layered this. So there is a cutout piece, and then the denim fabric is in the back. And then I raised this up on an oval shape, and then cut out a simple hello, and I double stacked it so it has a different shade of blue, and then the denim here to make it look like it popped out. And then I put those flowers here. I left the card plain on the inside for a personal sentiment to be in. I'll put my notes in there later, but I thought that this was a cute card to make with the denim fabric. Well, this is everything that I've created. I hope you all enjoyed watching what I've created, and please make sure that you go to Tmika's channel, and also visit her on her Instagram page, because that's where the challenge was actually hosted that she had. It was short, sweet, and simple challenge, and I hope you enjoy everything. And I want to thank everyone for watching my channel and continuing to watch, continuing with the supportive messages, and always making me feel happy and keeping me encouraged to continue to want to create beautiful things myself. So thank you to everyone who inspires me. I appreciate you all, and thanks again for watching. Have a wonderful day.